Mike Ralston from Blencowe Resources. Mike, good morning.
Good morning, Andrew.
Good to speak, Mike. Look, some news from you this morning. Met test work done on the Orom-Cross graphite project. Before we talk through the announcement here, just give us a quick update and recap on the project.
Yeah, so Blencowe Resources acquired the Orom-Cross project about 2.5 years ago. It's a huge graphite deposit in Uganda, in East Africa. And we've been developing it very quickly through to feasibility study stage. We completed a PFS in July. Very successful, great results, and we've moved forward into the DFS now. So the work that we're doing is the culmination of a lot of hard work to date and moving as rapidly as we can through towards that decision to mine, hopefully by the end of next year, with a view to production in 2025.
Right, so there's further met test work that's been done. What are we learning?
Well, what we've done here is we've taken the met test work that was originally done by SGS in Canada. And there are very successful results there. We can recap on those in a minute. But we've taken that same work, which produced about 5 to 7 kilograms of end product, which is the first stage. It's the bench testing. And we've taken it through on about a 10 times scale. So we produced around 80 kgs of end product, proving that we can deliver the same quality, the same end results from a much larger sample size, which is obviously taking us forward in stages through to the bulk sample testing next and ultimately through to main production stage. So it's very exciting. We've obviously proven that we can get similar, if not better results from this much larger scale upgraded test work than we had done before. And I think the consequences of that is to lead us through into the next stage, which will be our bulk sample testing next year.
And what is the status of the bulk sample test program?
Yeah, so Uganda doesn't allow for the export of raw materials. So we've had to go right up the chain, literally right up to the top, to get permission to do that. And that obviously doesn't happen in a heartbeat. But I'm very confident that we're going to get that export license very, very soon. And that bulk sample program will start. And that by that, I mean we'll be able to get our team to site and looking to obviously extract 100 tons from the representative sample at Orom-Cross to where we'll be mining and ultimately to take that through by container to China for test work in a pilot facility there in the first half of next year. So that will be the final stage testing, which we will call pilot testing, because at the end of the day, it is going through a pilot facility. And once we've done that representative sample of that size, and if assuming we can get the same results as we've achieved over the last two stages, then we've essentially proven that we can deliver it from the processing plant and the processing flow sheet that we've obviously done in these last two stages.
I think you may have mentioned this previously, Mike, when we last spoke, but you're looking for a funding partner here, are you?
Yes, I think it's very important that we go ahead and bring in a big strategic partner that can help us fund this project all the way through, not just through the DFS stage, but ultimately to fund the project as we implement it. I think one of the key challenges to graphite projects is how they're going to get built, how they're going to get funded in order to implement the project at the end of the day. And one of the things we've been working on over the last couple of months and continue to work on, because graphite's getting pretty hot out there, it's not quite to where lithium is yet, but I think we're heading in that direction. One of the things we've been working on is to try and find a strategic funding partner, somebody that's really good for the project, that can work with us, that can ultimately bring not just the funding, but other value add to the project along the way. So, yeah, I will obviously come to market when we've got something tangible to show, but I'm very confident in the direction this is heading, and I think that we're making great progress. So, with a bit of luck, we'll be able to get to the market quite shortly with some news on that.
And I suppose just finally, Mike, why is graphite getting so hot at the moment?
Well, graphite is obviously a non-replaceable key input item into the lithium-ion batteries. And lithium-ion batteries are essentially recharging everything in this renewable space. Obviously, the electric vehicles is gaining the most prominence, but there's plenty of other lithium-ion batteries charging everything from your TV remotes to your electric buggy on the golf course. But lithium-ion batteries require a lot of graphite. And we are sensing, and the market is forecasting, that there's going to be a huge surge in demand for lithium-ion batteries going forward. And that's played out by the fact that there are hundreds of gigafactories that are starting to get into various stages of planning and ultimately through to turning over their own battery production going forward. So over the next 5 to 8 years, I think there's going to be a huge step up in the requirement for these batteries and obviously for the input materials, including graphite. And I think that's on the demand side. On the supply side, graphite is a very difficult product to bring to market, mainly because every single project is completely different. The chemistry and the chemical characteristics of each project are completely different. And therefore, each and every graphite mine will have to go through a pre-qualification process where it takes its product through these various stages of MET testing that we're doing, and ultimately through to a 99.9% SPG product, and ultimately getting it OEM tested, so that the buyers of the product, before they sign offtake agreements, will want to know that the characteristics are obviously those that they can enjoy the benefits of, rather than lower quality. So yeah, we think that the graphite's got a huge future, and we're sitting on one of the best projects worldwide.
Good to see you, Mike. Thanks very much.
Thanks, Andrew. Have a good day.